You're getting an awful glare. You're getting a horrible glare off of that.
Pavarotti.
I was thinking more
more of the lead pipe variety.
Oh, drain pipe.
Drain pipes.
And if you see this, you might say, I'm like, hey, I'm a lead belly.
So we've got, what do you have for us now?
Well, the song's doing, it's actually a medley of Christmas songs, all that have a common theme, a theme of home. The reason for that is because I was thinking of all of the troops that we have, the men and women who are serving our country overseas, if I know we're away from home for the holidays. And so I wanted to do this as a tribute to them.
That's great. Let's hear the song you got.
Yeah.
Hey!
Yes, absolutely.
Don't feel happy. Okay. Next up, we have our good friend, Mr. Kevin Hawkins, all the way
the
from,
king.
From Mount Airy, North Carolina, but now lives in Hartsville.
Mm-hmm.
He's been performing for years doing a variety of music, including, well, you'll pretty darn awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, be nice. Of course.
can be nice.
Yeah. Tired and gentle. Kids love me.
By the way, what's this I hear about you trying to muscle in on the answer?
What?
Yeah.
I have the slightest idea what you're talking about.
Sure.
But if I were you, and you were me, and well, between you and me and you, wrap your mind around this.
Come on.
Well, seriously, listen. If 9 guys attack me, I cannot give each of them an equal beating. Some of them will get off with an uppercut or a flaming back fist because I just don't have the time. Now, if there was another awesome person with big muscles competing with me for beatings, then everybody gets the same beating. It's only fair. Kids work the same way.
What?
Yeah, well, anyway, I'm not trying to muscle in on the guy. Besides, he probably couldn't handle me in a fist fight.
Right.
And reindeer ain't for me.
What do you have to have reindeer to be standing?
Hey, don't tread on me, Floppy. After all, who wants to prance around with some wimpy radioactive reindeer all the time?
I see.
What Santa really needs is a flaming motorcycle that defies gravity, with saddlebags that blare out guitar solos, with giant flaming skulls painted on the sides, decorated in holly.
Did I make anything like that?
Have you seen my workshop? Of course I could. I mean, if I had a workshop.
Okay, well, whatever.
Anyway, it's time to sell these kids a new Santa. I mean, introduce myself as the new Santa. Oh, I mean,
yeah, right, let's get the point.
Work, right.
Right.
Uh-huh.
So,
right.
What?
Yeah, get to work. See ya.
I'll meet you over there in a bit. Oh, and straighten out that beard.
Down the hallway, we come to a large foyer full of parents and children, waiting to get their photo with, well, Dick Lucius, posing as Santa. The North Pole agency hired him because the real Santa came down with some food poisoning over Thanksgiving. And having missed that crucial time in his workshop due to the illness, he took a small leave of absence in order to catch up. In the meantime, we find Dick Lucius, Dick Lucius finds himself a little too at home while he sits on a quote-unquote train in the middle of the holiday Santa photo station.
Oh, man, what a comfy chair. Right. I wonder if this soft, cushy material matches my motorcycle.
All right,
Santa.
Hello.
Hey, kid, get over here. I'm Santa, kind and gentle. Hurry up.
You're scary.
Now, Timmy.
It's all right, ma'am. Not a problem.
Are you a real Santa?
Timmy!
It's all right, ma'am. I can handle this. I'm a trained professional.
Okay, well, if it's okay with you, I'll stand over here inside when we get ready to take the photo.
No problem, ma'am.
Why is your beard black?
What? Oh, my beard's coming off. Oh, sorry about that, kid.
I can still see it.
Right, well, be cool, okay? Don't worry. See you in the off-season. I'd like to keep my beard short and stylish. It takes time to grow back in. Should be back in by Christmas.
Oh.
Anyway, kid, what do you want for Christmas?
A fire truck.
A fire truck?
Uh-huh.
Why on earth would you... What are they teaching these kids these days? Look, kid. I cannot feasibly get you a fire truck. You have any idea how big a fire truck is? Matter of fact, I remember touring with Van Halen, not Van Halen. And we stole this fire truck and sprayed an entire Marble House. Anyway, it's just not in the stockpile at my workshop, which I have to say is pretty darn awesome. Much bigger than Santa's.
What do you mean?
Nothing, kid. I am Santa. Look, I'll make you a deal. I cannot get you a fire truck, but what I can do is get you a miniature motorcycle. With decorative skulls painted on the fender, snakes for handlebars, eating, flaming roses or swords or something like that.
Okay, I guess.
Sounds good, kid. I'll see to it. Next!
All right, Timmy. Mom, I'm getting a scary snake motorcycle. What? What are you talking about, sir?
Sorry, man. Kids got minds of their own.
I don't understand, Timmy. I thought you said you wanted a fire truck.
Oh, yeah. Ready for my next half customer. Oh, well, look at that little cute kid with the pigtails and the... And that high-pitched squeal.
Your
voice, it's so high.
Oh, my God.
makes you a whole lot quieter. How about a black stallion with red gleaming eyes and a tattoo of a guitar made out of bones and a drum set made out of skulls and roses?
No!
Entrepreneurial endeavor. Looks like I'm on the run again, but baby,
don't.
Thank you. for me. It's just a trick between them that you do it. And I can't make myself afraid, cause it's harder to know. Yours is hard and she's good, she's very much rattled. But this heart is weak and love's not a battle. Anyway, it's so nice to call you by your name. To have no one to take the sound of the heart. On a minute of a lift on the patio and a fly. All hints of them still feel dirty and a heart. And I sincerely hope you find somebody who's a stalker. I can't hold the children any longer. Marriageable daughter, I think that it's time. You lose your way from home again to your family in the sky. They live around the edges of some awful trauma. And fight to outlive the summer's drama. It's no good for nobody, no more around here. So go back to Washington where your name is so clear. At least good point, your people will devour your heart. And break your soul and come back to their God. Well, as to your soul, you'll be descending quite well. You're already made it up to 6 levels of hell. So don't hide the burden if you want to keep your heart. You know you shouldn't feel it broken to put beautiful heart. So go back to Washington and play Phoenix all your life. Your father will miss you, but so can you do right. Such beautiful energy, you know it'll be alright. Can play a Phoenix style all through the night. Go back to Washington, I'm sure some crowd misses you. There are already hundreds just lined up to kiss you. And leave the city and its great anonymity. But your father needs peace and his father. Well, I sincerely hope you find somebody who's stronger than you or your sister or your mother and father. And I sincerely hope you find somebody wiser than the fires you set on the prairie ride. So marriage with your daughter. So marriage with your daughter will be okay. Or at least that's what I'd like to say. Cause if I don't, there's a chance I might. But I can't afford that, not on a Tuesday.
Pages of lyrics and They don't tell, but this is still.
This song is called I Saw You. It's, like I said, another Bill Blood song.
I saw you looking at photos of me and they had destroyed the computer lies. And I saw you watch the filthiest things I've ever seen on yourself on my surfaces in my life. And I saw you through the last of the gorgeous revolution today. And I saw you smoking an olive charge from a chore with a man of 50s under the park. Everything is free to party. The Mayan calendar drum circles. The desk on your hair some shade of purple. You're crying a little about it. Cause it makes you feel so minor. Kind of super self-conscious. But it does get the blue sun of the day. And so what is kind of a blue shell? I mean, you were a dubstep DJ back in those days. I saw you drinking easy cheeses for the mythology presentation we have. Then I saw you eating tequila and peach trees and dessert on front of your eyes. And I saw you drive away all your friends and come back to have a good night. And I saw you in the waters 8 years ago. It was the strangest thing. Cause I didn't know you then, and I didn't live in the city. But I got a photograph of the dance floor and your body. The door of my boy's basement. I remember it. You dance hot and everything goes away. I think you weren't out for God knows. With a girl who liked Kentucky Bourbon. Any jewelry, I remember hoping you made it back someplace safely. So messed up reading my father's door, so we can get him to put back in full space. And I saw you every day in the night frame, home on the corner, static to a kill. And I saw you touching out weeping in the water when it rained, swimming like a hollow hook. And I saw you. It got way too intense. You started drinking some wine, you know, and all this smoke all the time. And I saw you in the morning light, coming this morning, trying to catch some flight. You had some friends out of Bombay. You synthesized your MDMA. You could finally get yourself out of the gray. I had to see you again after that day. And it was okay. You're already driven half my friends away. Except for the ones that really matter, they came back in a few days. Besides, I couldn't stand to watch you fade away. Cause even in that ancient photograph, there are weird little tracks about your eyes and lips. A defiant smile for even the cheapest lips. It was cute and thrilling, it was scary, the places you took your ring of this ocean of abandonment. So, I'm glad that you could get away. Even if not such a clean break, I remember hoping you made it back someplace safe. At this point, I knew you were probably more dangerous than any given block in any American city anyway. And you were. Without the intense yearning and certainly not any asshole playing. And I see you
into the traffic. You're there, but let you let you be Patrick Day. Well, whatever could get you. Something about habits, it's all about you. If you have that to represent your real world, it's not about real, real girl, girls. It's not as half as real as what I steal to sing about it, so I'll sing a song for thievery. To steal the stillness from the air. And there's no one here in this whole wide world who can tell me what it is that I try to steal from up there, especially not you. Or anything you do. And the CD still fine. Anybody want to buy it? It's got Arby's sauce on it.
We'll auction it off, man.
Chosen to delete an intensely graphic reenactment of Erwin and Dickie's
2-hour profanity-filled struggle to scale a 10-foot wall of sticky, runny effluvium. We now rejoin our characters at the top of the wall where they discover
a fortuitous tribute to our gentle perseverance.
Look at the Christmas lights, aren't they? Ah, that's what it got one end of the year it was. They even got a little pink tree in the window.
That's just a top flight frogger in your keep those silly holidays for determined hunters such as we.
Top flight hunters? Earth, we should check our scorecard here.
Easy, kid. You had a rough day. In fact, a lot grayed out from recent. But you come through it
like a chuck covered in what did that guy call it?
Effluvium.
Yeah. And if you have another stone, you're covered in it too. And it stinks.
You also have the frog in your pocket. Let's just go.
Well, how y'all doing there, fellas? Y'all come in and grab yourselves a table.
And Merry Christmas.
Thank you, man.
Oh, I mean happy holidays. I don't mean to offend.
Huh? No worries, ma'am. Let's take a seat over here, Dickie.
Let's sit over there by the window tree. Might take the edge off our sleigh.
I doubt it, Dickie. Little pink trees are pretty short on sap. But I guess it is Christmas.
Well,
we haven't had a real Christmas in years.
It's true.
Yeah, Dickie, stop touching it.
Well, my good intentions. You two are soaked to the bone. Let me get Jack to put him out here.
Wait a minute.
Settle down, Dickie.
How about some hot coffee, boys? Take the chill off.
Thank you, man.
I'll take mine extra black, please.
That's entirely understandable on a night like this. Say, what have you two been anyway?
Would your inquiry be in any way related to our dubious aroma?
Well, I don't mean to pry, but yes.
We can fish.
That's right, man. As my overzealous friend has stated, we are indeed in these parts.
Land sakes, how exciting. What do y'all boys fish? Catfish? Like most of those programs that they eat the tourists on?
No, not quite.
Crab? The talking bass? No, wait a minute. Those are two different shows. What's the one where this family just dip their beards in the swamp pot and bring up several varieties of marine life? Oh, swim is. That's the one.
Well, not quite, man.
Say, what night is that on?
Dickie.
How about swordfish?
Not quite, man. See, Dickie here can't handle being out at sea for more than a week, and I have a long-standing allergy to tuna.
Makes me feel nauseous thinking about it, and I'm prone to concussion.
I've heard those can be a headache. Well, trap? That doesn't sound quite as exciting now.
No.
Shrimp?
No.
No bass. No crab. No little crawlers. I give up, boys. What else is there?
Frogs.
Right.
The most aggressive of creatures knows no boundaries. At home in any clime, we seek
a frog.
The white frog! If then!
Call me Email.
Believe it! The thing besides, it's Ishmael. I apologize for our once again overzealous friend. I don't quite catch your name, miss.
Oh, well, my name is Tony. Thank you for asking. My father made me that. He was quite fond of food history, especially in certain dishes.
Interesting. Angry man.
Oh, don't stop. Terrible, dude. They'll make me go feel well now.
I'll laugh
at
her.
Shh, settle, Dickie. As I was saying, tourine, we seek frogs. Elusive crafts.
Delicious.
Frogs. We walked miles today in search of them. Back us at least 1,000 before becoming extracted by sheets of rain. It drove us to follow a high wall in the river. We eventually ended up by the mouth of a cave, lost most of our catch.
Safe and little, and I shall call you Squeezy.
Wow, that is a tale of owner's dramatic.
Thank you. I left out the more graphic portion.
Steve Blue.
Really, Dickie?
I was wondering. Would you boys be tootling around that little old four-fed Caesar by any chance? Gotta live free to die, stick around
here. No.
I thought as much. There's no bargain here. And those of you don't like our feelings, right?
The same.
You know, I saw y'all coming from the ditch over by my frog pond. You mean to tell me that's the river y'all came from? And it wasn't just a drizzle that just happened. Seek the rain.
I'm believe so, man. Tori.
Well, bless y'all, little hunts. Hope y'all didn't get my father's estate. I would do love them so. Every last one of them. I just love the same. Got a name for every one of them. Oh, but listen to me rambling on like a crazy woman that made a hat rack. You boys want that package. What can I get you there?
Well, it's been a while since we had a proper Christmas dinner. See, our families really never got together.
That's right. My dad was so avid a follower of televised sport that the Christmas of our place was called the playoff. And we'd live, and when he did his jackpot and put on a scratch ticket on the night of my graduation, he moved himself and 13 TVs into the guest bedroom. And none of us have seen him since.
What about you, huh? What's your story?
I don't like to talk about it much.
Oh, come on now. No judgment here.
Well, I come from a cookie family.
You mean cookie?
No, cookie. My dad owned a cookie empire. You might remember it. Elvish pretzels, cookies. Cookies that rock around the clock.
Oh my goodness, that was your family? Oh, I used to love me a box then at Christmas. What happened?
Well, my father became obsessed with making the perfect cookie, and I didn't love rockabilly music. He came up with all kinds, worked tirelessly, especially at Christmas. Anyway, the cookies eventually took his mind, and we lost it all to the moon. Well,
it's all right. You're going to have eventually.
All right, well, we eventually lost it all to the troops.
You mean like the Marines?
Worse, the Scouts.
Oh?
Of the young female variety.
Well, I never. Bless your little. Now, what now? That's just ridiculous.
Hey!
I mean, about the troops. I'm real sorry to hear about that. No wonder you're out here today. I mean, listen.
Oh, you know then. We do it because we like it. We like it a whole lot. It's the manliest thing to do. Since we never really had our fathers wanting to be dead around us, we figured, hey, fishing stuff, right?
Oh, I suppose. Not quite sure it is all about being tough. Nevertheless, bless y'all's hearts. Anyway, you two, we're about to close up now. What can I get you? I'll get it to go. And y'all know what? It's on the house.
Well, thank you, man.
Two rings.
Give it time. You know, I heard that for Christmas, most families have turkey or ham, so I'll have a ham sandwich.
And what about you, Homer?
Turkey sandwich.
All right, you see, I'll be right back.
Gee, Dickie, of all the nights we've been vlogging, this is the only night where something good has happened.
You know, you're right, old buddy. Hey, Ernie?
Yeah.
I know it's not really a manly thing to do, but being as it's Christmas, I decided to get you a present.
You were planning this all along, weren't you?
Uh-huh.
Well, thanks. You didn't have to. What'd you get me?
A pencil.
Huh?
So you could write your thoughts down.
Well, thanks, Dickie. Again, you're mighty consistent. But it's the thought that counts. Well, I got you something, too.
Oh, boy.
I found these tractor brakes in the embankment.
It's really, thanks.
Maybe one day we'll build us a tractor.
All right, here you go, fellas. Have yourselves a Merry Christmas.
Thanks.
A Merry Christmas to you. You want your doggy back?
Nah, you can keep him, honey. I named it Albert, by the way. He seems to take a liking to me.
Thank you for your kindness, touring. We'll never forget it. You know, Dickie, the waitress' generosity has got me to thinking, well, I think I'm trying to go visit my ma and share this sandwich with her for Christmas.
You know what? I think I'll do the same. I do miss home, and it's been a while since I've seen the hall.
Well, Merry Christmas, Dickie.
Merry Christmas, Earl.
All right, buddy, toss me the keys. I'm glad.
Son. Ah.
Once.
That's how we got this. Yeah, I can see how one out of two do that.
I was writing a pencil one time, just completely just hurt off my mind.
Well, Mama, don't allow no guitar playing.
Not Lutherans.
We have a commercial jingle to support the Preston Next Foundation. It goes something like this. If your guitar grows, come on. You know you ain't gonna run.
Right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. What we do is we've been asked to go out to one of the local schools in Pine Ridge. And we actually go out and bring our tools, and we actually show the kids how to make flutes. And you should see the kids as they embrace this, which was once their art, and it's now almost gone. And it's been a great honor for us to go out to the reservations and just share with them what they showed us what to do.
Wow, that's incredible. Well, we certainly thank you for what you're doing. And do you have a song, Chris, you'd like to share with us on? It looks like you have your own flute here that you made. This one a little bit different than the one you had last week.
Yes, that one was one that is going to a very special friend of mine. And this one is probably coming to your shop soon.
Oh, nice. Yeah, by the way, you can get these flutes at our shop, Fretson X, in Hartsville, South Carolina. And again, the proceeds go to Flutes for Hope. So Ken's going to share with us a song with one of his handmade flutes.
This is Silent Night, and let's see how it goes.
Thank you.
with us.
That was Cliff Chris from our days. Before we do our last one, I just want to give a little bit of history about Brooklyn Men. We're typically a 4 to 5, even up to 8-piece group. We started a year and a half, 2 years. I got a message from Pat saying, hey, you want to come and play some jam? And that's how we originally started. And then our warped brains began to merge together, and we started coming up with different ideas for some tunes. And so we're going to be doing a Christmas classic for y'all, 12 Days of Christmas, but with a little twist. And if you know the song, please, please sing along, because I think you'll enjoy it.
Yes, this is an old chestnut.
Very, very old chestnut. Good luck.
Here. We love you, Scott.
And Pat.
I love you, Pat.
And Pat.
Yeah.
Oh, glory. Proud,
stomach for 90 pirates, and not a single thought on his mind other than his instrument at hand, for God knows why.
Hey there, is that a nephew?
Hey, yeah, hey there.
What do you have there?
Guitar.
Yeah, guitar?
Yep.
Yeah, I see.
Yep.
So,
Is
there something wrong? Oh, excuse me.
The phone rang as it normally did to distract Shu from what he was doing.
I'm really sorry. Hello? No, I think you have the wrong number. No, I don't need diabetic testing supplies. I have the wrong number. Do I sound like Ernestine Wiggins to you?
Realizing it would be a while for Shu to convince the overseas operator that he was not an elderly woman in need of medical equipment, I intervened. Sorry about that. Let me see if I can help you.
Yeah, right, huh?
Let's take a look. Looks like you have.
Guitar?
Yeah, what you need is.
Guitar.
Yeah, I realize that, but what you don't need
is a broken guitar.
You're a pretty focused guy.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Let's just get back to your
guitar.
So.
Guitar.
Please, sir, allow me to diagnose this guitar.
Alright, I'm in a hurry.
It's okay. It looks like it needs some readjusting. The weather is starting to move it.
Move it where? I need to hear. Whose weather? What's she want with my guitar?
No. When the weather acts up, the
guitar
begins to move and twist a bit. We'll get it back to normal.
Oh, okay, alright. Well, hey, what would it take for you guys to customize my guitar?
You mean the guitar?
Yeah, of course, what's wrong with you?
Well, what would you like?
Well, I'd really like some graphics on my guitar.
Graphics?
Yeah. Maybe some skulls and snakes and maybe coming out of the cocaine and flaming roses, or maybe throw some big muscles and motorcycle engines. Oh, wait, no, that's my wallpaper in my bathtub. So maybe just the skull, snakes, flaming roses, something cool like that. Actually, I have this great image of the snake made out of motorcycles on my back. Here, let me flip to my shirt and show you.
Well, sir, I don't think that you have to do that.
Oh, no, you know what? Never mind. Just fix it. I can't think of the right combinations of snakes and skulls here.
Well, we can fix it, no problem.
Okay, but I will need it before Sunday to play at church.
Friend, we will not send God. We'll have it by Saturday.
Thank you, and have a blessed day.
See you Saturday. You'd be surprised at the number of musicians you wouldn't think are musicians today. And then you have mothers. Loving mothers of future musicians who have no earthly idea what they've gotten themselves into.
Oh my goodness, hello?
Hello, are you all right?
Well, yes, no, yes. Are you Mr. Shoes?
You mean Shoe?
Yes, I was told that he holds all the
answers. Who told you that?
Someone down at some place when they play the music, you know.
I see.
Well, my husband, who has a friend, who has an uncle, who has a sister, who has a daughter, who has a friend who takes lessons here. They said you need help.
Well, at this moment, she appears to be sharing his answers on the phone with a phony telemarketer.
How many times do I have to tell you? I don't know who Miss Wiggins is, and I don't need diabetic testing strips.
In any case, I too have some answers that could help you. How can I assist?
Are you sure?
I am sure.
Okay, well, my son, play this thing. It makes sounds, you know.
Guitar?
I think so. Does that make a noise?
Some look at it that way.
Well, my son plays it and it makes this noise a lot like my husband, Murray. It's an incredible noise, like when my X-Wank sings the national anthem.
He must be good.
Well, he doesn't have the age range of X-Wank, you know.
Really?
He can't make dogs howl. But his guitar sure does make a lot of noise.
As do most instruments.
But then I put it in the trunk and I heard this noise.
A noise?
Yes.
Man, did you put your son in the trunk too?
No, of course not. Who do I look like? I'm swanky to you.
Wait, how swanky? You put your child in the trunk?
Focus here. I accidentally took it away. I set the trunk. I heard the sound popping. Oh, this is terrible. It sounds broken. Can you help me?
Man, it sounds like it could just be swanky.
What's that?
That's what makes it work.
Oh my God. What am I going to do? My son's going to be devastated. It's the end of the world as we know it.
All right, calm down, ma'am. I think we can fix it.
Are you sure?
Where is it?
Well, my son got it.
Can you tell him to bring it in to us and we'll take a look?
Ezra! Get over here! He's over there now. Can you see him through the window? Can you see him?
Ma'am, do you mean the kid with a tuba? Sometimes you just have to roll with the punches. And not take yourself too seriously. That's what makes the job enjoyable after an episode like this one. After the dust settles,
and I directed a frantic mother to a tuba specialist. She was finally able to get off the phone. You get that pesky telemarketer straightened out?
I think so, Karen. It's a normal call anymore. But I did get talked into a 3-month subscription to Girl Scouts for me.
Really?
Hey, does she get a free box of cookies with any subscription?
That's not happening. Obviously, there are bigger problems than unwanted prescriptions in our day. We try to do our best to move along efficiently, artistically, patiently. This happens to be one of those days when our patience is taken to test. Thankfully, there are those glimmers of hope. It's when the sun breaks through a rainy cloud that keep us surprised and going. This evening, we had an unusual visitor. A little boy who couldn't have been much older than 9 or 10. You could tell he didn't have much and didn't need much. He wore a shabby tweed coat, blue overalls, with a hole in one knee. His hair a mess of brown tangle. But there seemed to be a bit of that good side. He had with him an ancient, looked like a harmony guitar, in very sad shape. The sort you find in a Sears catalog back in the day.
I got it!
Hey there, kid. How can we help you?
Hi, my name is Frank.
It's Frank. What are you carrying there with you? Don't tell me you're
an instrument.
Guitar! Oh, I didn't know you were there. Weren't you just on the phone with Clint?
Yeah, I was just selling a couple boxes of business, but that didn't take too long.
Why, Frank, right? Your guitar. Sorry about that. So what's your story?
Well, sir, my dad passed away a few years ago.
Look, here's a little bag of candy commemorating 1986 winter
You gotta be kidding.
What?
The whole experience of fixing this sort of guitar was like a very strange treasure hunt. The most interesting articles were some fly fishing hooks, round snake rattles, an old free Tibet bumper sticker, and the remnants of an Elvish trout sleeve. Among the torn binding, you noticed braces just on the inside of the guitar, right where you could see through the sound hole, were some words scribed as if some vandal thought it funny to enter to a tree. At first glance, we paid no attention, until at last we began finishing up the guitar, we realized it was a message. She read,
"To Frankie, I love you, my boy. It's not much, but play your heart out, Dad."
I guess you were right. And to think, you could see that this was important despite the frivolous cookie peddling.
Must have been this cookie that I ate before coming to work.
Oh, I'm starting to think you have a problem.
Don't worry, Ben, I assure you. My love for cookies comes before my love for guitars, before my love for cookies. Those, I guess, they all follow up from each other.
What was that?
Nothing.
That message was really pulled at our heartstrings, and so what would have taken only a few hours instead took 4 days. We were touched. We were inspired. We couldn't help having visions of grandeur that our good deed might fuel the talents of the next Eric Clapton or Doc Watson. So instead of just fixing the guitar, we decided to essentially turn a lump of coal into a diamond. When we were finished, it was beautiful, and it played amazingly. The sound was angelic, and we could not wait to see the expression on this boy's face.
Hey, Frank, what are you up to?
45 inches.
You're funny, kid, and short.
I'm not short.
Sorry, Frank. Anyway, we've got a surprise for you. Hey, Bill!
Coming! Hey there, Frank. Here's your guitar.
Wow, I love it. Why, thank you so much.
Not a problem, kid. Bill and I just wanted to do something nice.
Oh, but I'm afraid to ask. I can work for this if you let me.
No worries, Frank. It's on the house.
Wow, yippee, thank you all so very much.
Frank's excitement was so contagious. We couldn't help but have the biggest smiles on our faces. He turned around with his guitar and hurriedly made his way out the door as we heard him say,
"I bet I'll be able to make this up so I'll come."
Our smiles immediately turned into homemade grimaces. Obviously, we cannot help but think that our youth these days must be getting craftier and craftier. And the only question we could ask was, but why? How could anyone be capable of taking advantage of someone else's ID? Then again, how could any of us be so quick to judge? I beg my audience on a night like tonight to lay aside that cruel cynicism and pretentiousness we all tend to have, that so keeps us from believing in our fellow man. The stuff that keeps us from believing that there is still some good in the world, and it's worth fighting for. Because after we decidedly and selfishly convinced ourselves that whatever the motive, we did a good deed, we took a walk to let off some steam down the sidewalk in the Ville, South Carolina. It's a nice little town, artsy and bustling. A lot of people come live here from Ohio, Pennsylvania, Texas, Connecticut. And though they might not be small-town people, you find them on these streets, smiling as though they've lived here all along. And so when one takes a walk, it doesn't take long for that steam to subside. On we walked from our little shop, next door to the movie theater, across the street, peering into windows of shops that are just like us, barely making it by the skin of their teeth, still smiling, keeping that glimmer of hope alive. We walk past the aroma of good, strong, delicious coffee, the best little shop in town, and for whatever reason we forget, we start talking about almost snobbishly about the music we like at this time. And we make our way in the direction of that little dusty time capsule of a pawn shop on the corner at the end of the block. And then we hear the tiniest of sounds, with a hint of a shrill, affected voice due to the cold. It sounded like it could be a child singing, "Once in Rain, David City." The sun was still up, but not long away, and there were plenty of folks still scurrying about the sidewalk, completing their last-minute errands. Curiosity took us, made us impatient to see where this voice was coming from. When finally we made our way, largely pushing through the walking traffic, until we came at last to the corner, next to that tiny piece of a horn shop, where we found Frank sitting on a bucket with his guitar in his lap and a hat in front of him with a little bit of change. He could not play a chord to save his life, and the clashing of his fingers against the strings of his guitar made it happen for him like no other. But he was still singing from his heart at the top of his lungs, so that it almost drowned out the rude noises he made with his instrument. By the end of the song, his voice is all you can hear, and the hope therein being affected everyone around. And with that glimmer of hope in his eye, he very quietly looked up at us, crafty, selfish, rubbing the beards, and he said, "Thank you. Now you get my mom. And that's our story about some of the beards in a little town, Greville, South Carolina. Thank you.
Thanks so much, fellas. And we have a couple more songs for you this evening.
Yeah, we want to bring a couple people back up.
I'd like to ask Mr. Mal Weatherly, I believe he said he had a song. And I think Mal and Kevin and Doug have a song.
Yeah.
So we'll have you guys do that or something. Who goes first? I don't
know. We would say don't go for hours.
Yeah. Thank you guys so much for joining us this evening. And again, we'd like to thank Lula's Coffee Company. Thanks so much, Tommy.
And all our sponsors.
And all our people and sponsors. Thanks for, not that they sponsored, but Ustream makes it available for us to actually stream this entire show live. So
that
we're live right now, and that's kind of cool.
And I'd personally like to thank Al for helping me do my dance.
Albert!
Let's get out of here.
Alright, so they asked me if I would do another song. I said I would do a song that I wrote a while back. There are some other songs I've written that are about solutions. This particular song, it's about the struggle. But to do this, I need your help. I need everyone here, if you would. I need you to clap for me, okay? You're going to be my band, alright? So if you would, how about clap along with me?
Thank you. Fletcher?
And remember, folks, if you don't have a sound system in your car, grant you from 99 cents to sit in that seat and sing you one of his songs.
Oh.
And he works all alone.
You can also buy
this
CD with 3 packets of Arby's sauce inside. Whatever you want, donations and free breaks. Please for a hope. Just acapella.
Leave and travel well. Leave and travel well. Leave yourself and live to have to tell. I hope your heart will travel well. The moon will send you back. The moon will send you back. I prayed this night it would never pass, but I knew the moon would send you back so careful of our years. Careful of our years. I cried and fall. Worst of fears, but I'm so frightened of our years. I'll keep your name deep within. I'll keep your name deep within. Fight or fade or favor and sin is the name I've taken deep within. I saw such light in you. I saw such light in you. Crushed by the basement view, the night I lost my light in you. So leave and travel well. Leave and travel. And I hope your heart will travel well.
Carved a turkey.
turn the ball game on. Mix margaritas with an eggnog scone. Send somebody down to the stop and go. We need a bag of ice and a can of fake snow. A can of bean dip and some diet Sprite. A box of tampons and Marlboro Lights. Hallelujah, everybody say cheese.
Merry Christmas to the family.
Coming out tonight, and again we want to thank our artists.